What if this were all happening right now? What if Luke Skywalker were fighting against the Death Star and trying to rescue a princess?
Terminate her immediately.
What if you could go with them? Well, you can. Tomorrow at a theater near you. Star Wars, rated PG.
The people in this crowd will soon be among almost 40,000 who have seen a new science fiction movie at North Park Cinema 2. The movie is called Star Wars. The movie made $2.6 million nationally during the first 3 days it played. Although lines at North Park Cinema stretched to more than a half mile long and the movie cost $3.75 a person, no one tonight seemed to mind the crowds.
The taping sessions overall ran 28 hours, 45 minutes. Frost had the right to select what he wanted from the tapes. He had complete editorial control, he says, down to the four 90-minute segments that will be broadcast.
Well, when I said, I just hope I haven't let you down, that said it all. I had. I let down my friends. I let down the country. I let down our system of government and the dreams of all those young people that ought to get into government but will think it's all too corrupt and the rest. Most of all, I let down an opportunity that I would have had for 2.5 more years to proceed on the great projects and programs for building a lasting peace.
Now you don't need messy charcoal to get that great charcoal taste. You don't need dangerous starting fluid. You don't need to light match after match. Now there's the electric charbecue. It comes with permanent briquettes. Plug it in anywhere and you'll get that great charcoal taste. The portable electric charbecue. It makes old-fashioned barbecuing really old-fashioned.
The Contempora Electric Charbecue, on sale at all leading department stores.
An all-new challenge for Peter Falk as Columbo. Then, first time on TV on the big event, the story of Princess Grace. She played love scenes with Hollywood's most famous leading men. She shared her real love with a European prince. Catch an informal glimpse of her family life with Lee Grant.
A success, if you have no one to share with, isn't much fun.
Interviews with stars like Bill Holden highlight this fairy tale come true. An all-new Columbo, then the story of Princess Grace, next Sunday night on NBC.
Murder on the ski slopes, and the case is too hot to handle.
They are prime suspects.
But I'm not going to start an international incident. Now, that is the American biathlon team, not a bunch of hippies living out of a van.
The only chance for Hogg or me to go to Lake Placid is if one of the regular team members can't make it.
Yeah, like if one of us got killed.
See The Deadly Triangle. First, Robert Redford narrates The Predators, then Hollywood High, followed by The Deadly Triangle. Thursday, starting at 8, 7 Central and Mountain Time.
face the hardest times you could imagine. And many times her eyes fought back the tears. And when her youthful world was about to fall in, each time her slender shoulders bore the weight of all her fears, and a sorrow no one hears still rings in midnight silence in her ears. Let her cry. She's a child, let the rain fall down upon her. She's a free and gentle flower growing wild.
In the shadows of the tall timber, the creatures of the forest gather, a growing horde of beak, tooth, and claw. This is the day of the animals. Struggling for survival in a world gone mad, the hunter becomes the hunted.
No!
The day of the animals is coming, and there's no place to hide. Rated PG.
Suppose tomorrow, real theory, mm-hmm. that all human beings disappeared from the earth, mm-hmm. and it was left to just the birds, the fish, mm-hmm. the reptiles, and the animals. Do you think that they would evolve eventually into...
Well, I think
speaking,
I think there's no doubt about it.
Or is that evolutionary pride? Have we gone past that?
No, I think it's very likely. I mean, by and large, other things being equal, it's better to be smart than to be stupid. There are some exceptions, like when you make nuclear weapons, but before that, it obviously gives you a better chance of survival, a better chance of leaving many offspring. And the question, it's an interesting question, which organism would replace us if we wiped ourselves selectively out? An old professor of mine, H.J. Muller, geneticist, said he thought it was between the raccoons and the bears. And they're both very clever and do many different things. But my feeling is that the great apes, chimps, gorillas, are so close to us already that they have a big head start if that were to happen. I hope it won't happen. And the way you guarantee that it doesn't happen is by using the kind of intelligence that nature has already given us.
Gonna whoop him, miss. Now, that's the latest. And I know you're gonna help because you're the greatest.
Join Muhammad Ali in the fight against multiple sclerosis.
Driver in the car.
Universal presents The Car, rated PG.
For the first time on television, Bob and Dolores Hope discuss their 43-year marriage.
Every marriage has those early and middle and not very many late bad spots.
Bing Crosby talks about his recent accident and his family.
What about the older four boys? They had a lot of problems.
Well, I must have left something undone.
Red and Joy Fox discuss their life and Red's career.
Gonna have freedom.
The Barbara Walters Special.
Tonight at 10, 9 Central and Mountain on ABC.
When the Airline Passengers Association surveyed frequent flyers and asked them to pick their number one choice for domestic travel, the winner was American Airlines. But maybe we were just lucky. More recently, the Opinion Research Corporation asked virtually the same question. And this time, the winner is American Airlines. Chosen number one twice in a row. That's not being lucky. That's being best.
This is Smokey and the Bandit. The story of a lazy weekend in Alabama, Texas, Mississippi, Arkansas, Georgia. Burt Reynolds, Sally Field, Jerry Reed, and Jackie Gleason as Sheriff Buford T. Justice in Smokey and the Bandit. Rated PG. What we have here is a complete lack of respect for the law.
It's the toughest of the tough. The trial of the turf for a young girl jockey.
Racing ain't for women, it's for men. Women ain't got what it takes. Guts.
It's against rules, and you know it. We could bar you from this track. Be sure to tune in next week for Bluegrass Special.
Introducing the all-new
Herbie.
It's Walt Disney Productions' Herbie Goes to Monte Carlo. The love bug is bitten by the love bug.
I'm telling you, Paris, the women have got him.
Herbie finds the car of his dreams and a stolen diamond in his tank.
$6 million.
Pull over.
And we got the old Herbie back.
Herbie Goes to Monte Carlo, rated G. Head over wheels hilarity from Walt Disney Productions.
The Andersons, a father knows best 20 years ago. The Andersons today. It's Jim and Margaret's 35th wedding anniversary. Robert Young, Jane Wyatt, Eleanor Donahue, Billy Gray, and Lauren Chapin star in the Father Knows Best reunion. Then David Niven hosts the star-studded special The Billion Dollar Movies, honoring Jaws, The Godfather, The Graduate, and other giant hits. The Father Knows Best reunion and The Billion Dollar Movies on the big event.